Flame of Kali. Orange of the Queen's Day. Inspiration.
Michael Bowen. Painter, hippie icon, a living monument from the 60s. And yet, here in Amsterdam, painting Queen's Day. And even dressed right. In a Queen's Day t-shirt he picked up yesterday.
Right.
Welcome, Michael.
Thank you, Luke.
How do you see yourself? Are you a painter? Are you a political activist?
That's a good question. No, I'm a painter. But the only reason I ever got involved with politics, and I'm not involved with politics, but so-called things I've done that are, you know, people keep talking about, the activist things were there done because if they weren't done, I couldn't be free as a painter. As simple as that.
Do you think the expression in paint is as much in danger as the expression in print?
Of course it is. Look what happened in Russia, you know.
People were not allowed to paint what they wanted?
Of course they weren't. They weren't allowed to paint what they wanted, and they ran them out, and, you know. So, yeah. In fact, art is controlled by any type of state, including a corporate state, first. They want to control the artist, definitely. One way or the other, either they pay them off, like the communists did, or they suppress them, like the Nazis did, and evaluate up some other form that fits with their politics. Or, like happened in the United States during the Depression, when most of the artists were painting social themes, and that was the big thing, really. The trustees of the museums decided they would put a stop to that after the Rockefeller mural by Diego Rivera and that huge publicity that happened when they busted his mural up because he put Lenin or something in it. Anyway, what those trustees did, those powerful people in the corporate world, is they said, okay, from here on out, we're going to find a kind of art that we're going to support that says nothing, essentially, and is aesthetically oriented. And so that they did that. And that was very, very successful. That brought through also a whole new thing. It brought through people like Pollock, who really who show the molecular and the vast cosmic at the same time, from our point of view, or our place, state of being. So, you know, they don't... The suppressors are not successful, but they do try. And they haven't... They are starting in the United States right now. I just left the United States and do not intend to go back until they change the police state. And I'll ask them, please change the police state. But I don't think they're going to do that. So then I'm not going to go back.
Okay, so, but you are, in a way... someone who has witnessed the 60s or part of the 60s.
Of course. Yeah.
The Summer of Love is your thing because together with people like Alan Cohen, you made that thing happen with.
That's
tell
right.
me about that human being, that first human being out there in San Francisco.
Well, first of all, the real story of the human being people don't really know. That is that. Very wise people had worked out the necessity for a reversal, a kind of a reverse change in human consciousness many, many years before 1967. And I started working with those people in Mexico in 1957, in San Francisco in 1957, in Mexico in 1963. And
we're talking about people who went to Mexico to see the culture and came in contact, for instance, with the psychedelic.
No, not at all. Although they were involved with people like Gordon Wasson and other people like that. No, these are not at all. These people are different than that, and they basically worked out the necessity for a complete change in human consciousness, a reversal in the way people think, because by the time we reached what we've reached now, 2005, 2006, we have, what, 6 billion people on the planet. So there's a whole lot of things that can't happen anymore that are happening, like war, for example, and many things. And so the old archetypes have to reverse, literally reverse.
But they picked that up in Mexico.
Well, it was put together in Mexico. The BN was put together as a concept. I was sent from Mexico to go, from Tepoztlan, Mexico, to go to New York in 1964 to find Leary, which I did. At that time, he was not easily found. To find Leary and to bring him back into the same mandala people that that had started working with him in 1961 in Tepoztlan, Mexico, and in Cuernavaca, without his knowledge. His if you read his stuff, his greatest experience he talks about and so on and so forth took place with a mushroom down there. It wasn't LSD.
And he got turned on,
right,
because of the mushrooms, the magical mushrooms that were found in Mexico.
Right, but it's not the magic mushrooms by themselves. It's the set and the setting and the people and the structure and the fact that he was actually chosen and picked by agents of, there's Tim, chaos theory.
So later, of course, he was much older, but his...
Yeah. Well, we had a lot of fun together.
And what you see there, what strikes me is that psychedelic art, that mm-hmm. art form by repetition of patterns.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And of course, we're lying here on an old kaolin, which is mm-hmm, an old mm-hmm. Persian thing, and the same patterns come up in there. So there's really nothing new, and yet this was, in the 60s, very new.
Well, it was new for this culture, because this culture was, meaning not this culture necessarily, in Europe, but in the United States, it was rigid, and it was militarized to an extent that it's hard to believe.
So did human be in? You say you went to New York to figure out how to do it, what to do.
No, not exactly, no. What happened is that I was sent to New York from Tepoztlan, Mexico, to find Timothy Leary. The reason was that Leary had been an experiment of John Starr Cook's in Mexico in 1961 without his knowledge. That's the mushroom opening that happened to Leary, which he writes and talks about. What he didn't understand was that was actually coordinated structured by John Starr Cook and the other people involved. He was picked because of his Harvard thing and the rest. He was picked as a person to possibly carry this message of change. And so by 1964, John wanted to check on this progress and see what had happened, because Leary was making a lot of noise by that time. He'd done if, and he'd done this and that. So I went to New York from Mexico to find him, and I found him magically.